Dashboards summarize a lot of data in a compact format. You should avoid the temptation to display too many items on a dashboard, but there will be times when you want to make certain information easily available, even if it's not shown all the time. You can do that by hiding worksheet rows that contain some of the details displayed in the dashboard by creating custom groups. I'll show you how to group and ungroup rows in this movie. The top portion of this dashboard worksheet contains information such as room service revenue, guest count, department expenses, and then a pivot chart indicating quarterly expenses by department. Starting in row 11, you can see that I have target quarterly expenses by department in 2017, and then I have the targets in rows 12 through 15 for each of my four departments. The thing is, I don't really need to see the targets, but I'm assuming that the manager who's using this dashboard wants to know that information at least occasionally so they can remind themselves of the targets. So I guess we have to have it here, but we can hide it so that it doesn't take up as much room on the worksheet. To hide rows that you don't want to display all the time, but that you do want to be easily accessible, select the rows that you want to hide, and then on the Data tab of the ribbon, in the Outline group, click the Group button. Doing so defines a group based on the rows that you selected. And you can see the indicator here, which tells you that you have a group. And then you also have currently a Hide Detail button. If I click that, then the rows are hidden. But because row 11 was not part of the group, it is still displayed. Also note that the Hide Detail button is now a Show Detail button. And you can see it has a plus sign, which indicates that clicking it displays more data. That's how you create a group. If you want to ungroup, then select the rows. And then on the Data tab of the ribbon, in the Outline group, click the Ungroup button's down arrow, and then click Clear Outline. And doing so gets rid of all of the grouping that you'd done. You probably noticed that creating that group meant that the rows below the group became visible when we hid the data. And it can be tempting to put regular dashboard elements below rows that you've hidden, but you shouldn't do it. If you need to, you can always insert additional rows in your worksheet. To do that, just go to any worksheet row header, right-click it, and then click Insert to insert a new row, and you can continue adding data and regular dashboard elements as you need.